So today we are going to be discussing the summary of data structures in Java. So we already know that we have various data structures in Java, such as linked lists, stacks, queues, sets, and maps. So we are up to discuss all those things. The maps are very much important. So then we have to know about what is the data. What is the data? So data is the computer. Data is information passed stored by computer. This information may be by the form of the text, documents, image, audio clips. So that is various types of data is available. Simply, what are the things we are going to be stored on computer? So such type of data is going to be stored in the digital format, zeros and ones. So such type of things are going to be known as computer data. So computer data may be processed by using computer CPUs, whatever the peripherals, what are the things we are going to be using external, all those things we are going to be used to store the data in them. Okay. So at the basic level, the branch of this one is we know already zeros and ones. So just is already discussed one. I'm going to be just brief thing I am going to be doing. So you know computer data is a binary and zeros and ones is going to be. Because all the computer data is a binary format, can be created, processed, and saved, stored digitally. So there is a form of digital. So this allows the data to transfer from one computer to another computer by using a network connection of various media services. It is also does not decline over time or low quality or being multiple times also. So if the data is there, if you are using multiple times, there is no error. Nothing going to be happen with the data. So simply how we are going to be, so, you know, if we are going to be reading data and disk, the data is continuously reading. The disk is going to be blocked, but we are going to be store the data in the meaning caches. So anything is going to be happen like this. Still we have replications. So through that we are going to create the data. So replications of data is there. There is no problem with the data. There is no if multiple times we are going to use the data. There is no loss of quality also. So that is the thing. So we know the programming data, where the programming data is going to be stored, variables, what is a variable. So how we are going to be assigning the data to variable, whether it is a compile time or runtime. So we have arrays and the structures. What is the difference between arrays and structure? So we have a data structure. What is the form of data? How we are going to be organized in a formatted manner. So in order to access the data in a better manner. So here we have arrays, pointers, structures, and linked stack. All those things are there. Graphs, sorting, programming, etc. We have all those things are there to manage the data. So here we have arrays. So let me give you one more different type of TPD. So in order to know how the data is going to be stored in array, so please mute yourself. Don't disturb in between. Okay. So how we are going to be store the data in arrays? Let me show you in the PPT. I'm going to start this. I'm going to share the new PPT. Please wait 1 second. I'm going to do it. So my screen is visible to everyone. So can someone answer? My screen is visible to everyone.
sir.
Yes. Okay. Thank you.
Visible, sir.
Okay. See now the data representation methods. Data representation method. How to represent the data? So we know that various data structures are there to represent data. So if you take one of the thing is arrays and another one is linked list. So now we will see only array in this part. So see that what is a linear list of array representation. For example, you know the one-dimensional array. So we know one-dimensional array, two-dimensional array, three-dimensional, multi-dimensional arrays. Everyone knows. So we know the basic thing of what is a one-dimensional array. So how we are going to see this? So this is the array. So the red color we have numbers now. That is known as index, array index. So it is gives the data where it is going to be stored. Through the index number, we are going to be retrieve the data from the array. So this is known as, for example, we are going to recall this is a linear list. So n is equal to the comma comma comma. So this is the data we are going to be inserted into an array. So how we are going to be inserted the data into an array? So store the elements, element I of the list of element of I. So that is I is the index number. So have you remembered the concept? What is the concept of array? So then will I tell you on the day when I'm going to be explained. So don't array is a group of data, similar data are going to be storing common under one name, such type of things is there. But we need to remember the one basic concept is there. So that is why we came to arrays instead of leaving the variables. So can anyone remember what is the background concept of arrays? So we need to know the continuous memory allocation. Have you remember continuous memory allocation? So we have continuous dynamic memory allocation, static memory allocation, all those. So arrays are going to be considered as a continuous memory allocation. What is this continuous memory allocation? How the arrays continuous memory allocation is going to be done? So arrays, we know that arrays are the group of similar data. So if the similar data means all type of data in a similar manner. So that is it will be a character or integer or float or double or whatever. So once first we say we are going to be fixed what type of data we are going to be storing. So such that we are going to be confirming that the size of the data. That is, for example, character. So the size is 1 and integer size is 2 bytes and float is 4 bytes and double is 8 bytes. So once the data is going to be confirmed and the size of the data type is confirmed, then we are ready to insert the data into the array. Then array, the basic address is going to be very, very needed. So that is later on, once the basic address is going to be given by the program, then later on it is going to be incremented by the size of the data type. Have you remember that one? For example, here we are going to be considered as, so these are the bottom of the things are there. So these are all the characters. So now I'm going to be mention arrow of L. So L data type is char. So for example, I'm going to be mention L of, so the array name is L. For example, see that, how we have char. So L, for example, what is the size we need to mention? So if you mention, for example, total how many 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 characters are there. So 5 characters means directly it will give you size is 5. So now usually the array index is going to be start from 0 to n minus 1. So 0 to 4, total 5 values you can store. So how this continuous memory allocation is going to be happen? So usually we have n of 0. Is going to be get the memory address. So for example, memory address means, for example, I'm going to be mentioning 1,000. If I'm going to be mentioning 1,000 per the first character, so that we are going to be inserted into here. So A. Now this base address is going to be 1,000. Base address is going to be 1,000. So later on the continuous memory allocation. So I mentioned this is the character. So what is the size of character is 1 byte. So if it is 1 byte, then what is going to be happen? Next 1,000, 1,000, 1,000, 2, So like that, the continuous memory allocation is going to be done in the arrays. So here the main concept is base address. So the base address is going to be allocated to get the address first, then later on it is going to be continuously incremented one by one. So if it is a character, if it is just integer, what is going to be happen? 2 bytes, 2 bytes is going to be. So storing the elements I from the list of element of I. See that how the first value A is going to be stored in index 0, the second value, third value, fourth value. So total 5 values are. And what we are going to be doing is on array. What we can do? So we have same thing, we can do the left to right mapping also. So this is the way we can change. So the previous one we have. So 0 to this one. And then left to right also we can array. So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2. Like this we can also have. So here we have various where generally we know that only 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, up to. So while representing, we can represent from left to right also. So this is the way we can A, B, C, D. So now what is going to be happen? So A is intercepted. So in such manner, if it is the implementation concept, it will be very useful. So the Q concept, what is going to be happen? Q or stuff. So both of them can be implemented by using arrays. So that's why we learned stack using stack implementation by using arrays. So Q's implementation by using arrays. So that like the way we are going to be doing. So in such concept, we can insert the data from left to right or right to left. So mapping the things, what is going to be happen? So that skips everything positions. We can change the positions. So the mapping concept is we can change the position. So we can implement, we can change the order of the data. We can insert it into one after one. So we can change the positions. We can change the various positions. So and also we can map around, wrap around the map. So what is this? See that? So some data we are going to be using left side, some data we are going to be using right side. So two data in left side and three data in right side. So again, so the representation used in text. So how it looks? See this? So this is the basic data type. So we can find. So put the element I in the list of element I. Then what you can do? You can use the variable size around the record, the parent number of elements. How many number of elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So don't count to the index number. Because index number always starts from the 0, we cannot include the size is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Only the size is 4. No, it is not. So it is going to be sizes. We have to count the number of variables, number of data in the elements, number of elements in the array. So that we can conclude that. So what is the size here? 5. So if the size is 5, that only before I mentioned char log 5. So then that is 0 to n minus 1. And size is 5. So how to add and remove an element? How to remove and add an element? So how to, so for example, add 1 comma 0. So set concept is 1. So that is, so already in the position, so that is 0, 1, so index position 1, we have the B value. So how we can add the new value? So if you add up 1, 0, the new value is going to be inserted. So that means the old value is going to be replaced. How it will be? Generally, we can initialize an array, then later while we are going to be print, we can easily print it. In between, we may assign some value to the predefined array. So again, the concept of recent values. What is the recent values? So it is always consider the recent value which we assign to the variable that is going to be taken by the variable. So data types in array elements. So data types are the list of the elements is unknown. So define the elements of data to be object. So we cannot put the elements of a primitive data types. So that is, we cannot put different types of data elements. That is our basic concept of arrays. So we can put any similar type of data into the array. So it's a linear list. So how the length of the array elements? So do you know how the elements to be, elements will be to be in the list? So must look up an initial length of the dynamically increasing is needed. So that is a dynamic loop. So how it is a dynamic loop? So once the array index is going to be dynamically given, then later on it is going to be a continuous memory allocation. So if the length of the array is 6, so that is if I am going to be inserted, before that the length is 5, now I am going to be inserted a new value. Now how we are going to be, first we can create a new and the larger array. So we need to increase the length, how we are going to be doing that. See that? So this is that. We are creating a new object. We are initializing the size is 50. So that is, we are going to be considered the new array is equal to new object. So I'm going to be increase the array length. So now the array length is predefined increased. So this is the predefined 6. Size is 6. 6 elements is there. I need to insert the more data into the array. What I need to do? First of all, I need to do the incremental. So that's why here the dynamic concept is given. What is the dynamic memory allocation? What is the dynamic memory allocation concepts are there? So malloc, calloc, vue is there. No? So there we are going to be using. So by using Java, we are going to be creating an object for the global data type. So then we are going to be removing. So here we have a new array equal to new object 15. Now the 15 empty spaces was created. Now copy the elements gold data. So now I am going to be copy that this is the gold data. I am going to be keeping to the new data. Now finally rename the new array. So that is element equal to new array. Now how it will be renamed? So now the final length is 15. So see that? So creating a new array proper length with the data. So object array, so that is gives the square bracket gives it is an array. New array is equal to new object of new length. So this is the proper line. We are doing this for the our world. So copy the all the elements to the old data. How we are going to be copying? So system array copy of element comma 0 comma new array comma 0 some length we are going to be doing. Okay. So how the rename? So element equal to new array. So this is a simple programming lines. Here we are. The dot lines are the previous one. No? So element dot 0 comma new array comma 0 element length. This is a simple program how we are going to be do the array size increment. So integer is equal to new array of 10. A equal to integer of change in length of 10. So this will give us directly. We cannot directly do the size. So first of all, we need to increment the array, then only we can insert the new data. So we cannot directly do it. It gives n. So how big it should be the new array B? So at least one or more than current array. So storing one or more element. At least we need one value to insert into array. So the copy the increasing of length is that is A of new length. So this is the simple mathematical formula. We know that how we are going to find the notations from big O notations also small O how we are going. So if the const of n added to be the operation dynamically the empty linear increased by that is n squared. So you know have you heard this space complexity? So if the space complexity is there, another word is going to become this time complexity. So vice versa. So what is this space and time complexity? So every programming language, simple before going to finish. So we can write additional two number programming in C language, C++, and Java, Python, any language. Which language we can write that program? So all languages you can write that additional two numbers. So which one is a better one? Which one is a better one? Which one is an easy one? So how we can analyze the program? Which program is a better one? For example, you know all the languages. If I ask you to write a program, in which language you prefer to write? Why? Anyone? Which language do you prefer to write? So if you say one language, I am going to be asked why it is, for example, somebody said it is easier to learn. For example, now I have to see it in Python. So we have simple lines we can add. But in a C language, we need to include all those things from starting to end. Header files, main function, index, signalf, getting values, putting values, all those things, then finally writing an expression and do. Finally, we need to print them. So by 2-3 lines, we can finish that Python language. So how we can conclude that which language is easy to learn, which language is more effective? So which language takes the number of lines, which language is to compile fast? So that is the point. So which language programs take the less space, that is the space complexity. Which language programs runs fast? So that is the time complexity. So both things will come in order. So how we are going to be increased one. Speed is 2 into new length of n minus 1. So 7 minus 1 is 6, 6 into 12. 6 into 2. So that is the maximum length we are going to. So array of doubling. So doubling the array length. So how we are going to do this? A simple formula is how to do double. So 6 into 6 is 12. No? So that is 4. So that is again 1.5. So it should not take 1.5. We don't have any speed in points. Simple array declaration by using this, adding the multiplication of instance, word size and usage. So resizing by addictive term and increasing the cost of n operation, that is n square only. Cannot do that. So we can do only the squares, that is 6, 6, 12. 5 means, so what type of data is there now? That is depend upon. Is 1, 2, 4, 8, the size of the data types also like the way. So that's why only. If the 3 is there now, for example, if the already predefined size is 4 data are there. So we conclude that 4 data types are the characters. Again, we need to increase by 1, 1, we need to increase. Then later, integer, we need to increase by 2, 2, 2. So that is based upon the type of data. So that's my limit. In the starting itself, we discuss about what type of data we are going to store and what is the size of the data we need to know. So this is about the sizes of these data. Then how come it is useful in Java? So that is about simple arrays, how it would be. Then we have a data structure, linked list, double linked list, circular linked list, and circular double linked list, and the stacks are there, and the queues are there. So still we have not only this one, we have trees and graphs also. You know what is the binary tree, binary search tree, BL2 and B3 and B+2. And another one, graph implementation. At the best search and best of search, minimum spanning tree algorithms. And once the data is with the graph or trees, then how we are going to be doing searching and sorting algorithms. For searching, linear search and binary search, and sorting, we have a bubble and all those things. Before going to be linked, I will show you one more small PPT for a stack, how the data is going to be. Very much useful for stack. The data is going to be stored. Screen is visible to everyone. Can someone answer? The screen is visible. So we know the stack is a list with restriction that the insertion and deletion can only perform the top and end of the list. So what is the points in the stack means? So we cannot perform like arrays, we cannot directly insert it in between directly change the value in between. So that is insertion and deletion can perform only. So we have some restriction with the data. So that restriction is known as last in first out. So the data is going to be pushed into the stack. The last, the data is going to be deleted first from the stack. So we know that last in first out. So I told you one more definition. So I already told you, don't say you came to final year, should not say that it's the last in first out concept. What is the stack means simply things it is the last in first out. So what I told you, what I have told you, what I told you on that day. So what we have to give in different definition by the stack. So immediately we need to say the stack is a linear data structure which operation can perform on one end. So that is maybe insertion and deletion can perform at one end. So that definition. So linear ordered list. Linear list. So we have to select. So don't say simply it is the last first out. So the elements are stored in order insertion by not think that having indexes. We don't have any indexes. So the client only add and remove XML elements added data. So the basic operations are push, pop, and peek. Push, pop, and peek. So we can insert the data and we can remove the data. So push operation, pop operation, peek operation. So these are the three basic operations are there. One second, I will show open again. Some error is going. So the applications of stack. What are the applications we can perform on the stack? So methods are called basically. So push and pop, call and return. What are the things are there? Method one and method two. So that is, we know the return value, local value. So we know what is the local parameters and global parameters. So matching up of the related pair of things. So find out the whether the string is a palindrome or not. XML the file to be in a brackets with the operator match. So what are the operations we can do? So that is how we are going to evaluate an expression. So post with expression, prefix expression, how we are going to be evaluate. So for evaluation in between braces, we are going to iterate how we do the match. Then sophisticated algorithms are searching through the maximize with the backtracking. So in our backtracking, dynamic programming. So these are the things are there now. Divide and conquer. So what is the meaning of backtracking? What is the meaning of backtracking? So for example, in sorting algorithms, we can see the backtrack. What is, so we are finding for the element. So for example, if first itself we can find that element in the array or any list. So we'll stop that finding. We need to go to the at the last of the size, that is the last of the requirement. It has to back whether how many elements are there in the list and it has to show. So backtracking, searching through made up of the back. And many programs using undo stack, the previous operations, that is a push and pop operation, how we can. So these are the classes of stack. So stack, whether is known as elements, how we are going to be inserted in the stack. So the meaning of here, see that everything we are going to be considering as a generic types. So that's why the brackets are there. So construct a new stack with an empty data. And elements are type E. Then push the value into the stack. Pop, remove value from the stack. So for removing, whether we need to mention the value. So see that here the push in bracket we have value. In pop, we don't have any value in the bracket. Which value you can put? Why there is no value in the pop operation? because we are going to be delete only one thing. So which value at the top, that value only we are going to be delete. So whatever it may be the value, we are going to be delete. Don't need to put the specification of particular value. But inserting what the data, for example 20, we are going to be inserting. So what data we are going to be delete? For example, the order we have a stack. For example, I am going to be draw one stack. So here we have a 10 and 20 is there. So for example, it's a stack, two values are there. So the top equal to 0, top equal to minus 1, top equal to 0, 1 is going to be like this. So 0 to 1, 1. If I am going to be mentioned top values, so initially it is the top equal to minus 1. When it is 0, then the value is inserted. If it is like that, so if I am going to be perform the push operation, what? So push R. For example, I am going to be insert 30. So what is going to be happen? 30 is going to be replaced. Then automatically top value is going to be. Now how we are going to be, just we can simply we can apply pop operation. Is going to be directly take what is the top of the element in the stack is going to be deleted. So no need to mention the value. So normally there is no declaration about the values in the top option. And peep also it is written the top of the value, which value at the top it is going to be written the peep. Then size, what is the size of array? Whether in the stack operation you need to consider. So overloading. So what is that overloading and underflow and overflow? What is underflow? So we are trying to delete the data if the stack is empty. What is overflow? Still we are going to be insert the data when the size is already the top of the stack is matching with the size of the stack. So then still we are going to be insert. So if we have one bucket, so 1 liter of capacity of bucket is there. Can you insert the 2 liters of water in the bucket? Still we are going to prefer what is going to happen. It is going to be overflow. Same that is the concept. So in the capacity of 1 liter bucket, can you fill 1 liter? Then we can remove only 1 liter from the bucket. We are trying to remove 1.5 liter and 2 liters. No, there is no nothing data, nothing water. What is that? Process of the stack. So these are operations, push operations, how we are going to be inserted. So for pop operation we don't need anything. So but also we cannot do the looping also. So once we can have a list of data, then automatically we cannot do the insert data. So please remember this one. So we cannot make loop over the stack like we were to list. So previous one array we can know. So how we can, by using the loop we can insert the values into array. So but we cannot do this stack. So instead of putting that we are going to be check it whether the stack is empty or not. Then we can continue with that. So the pop operation or then we can go with inserting a new. So is empty, is full. So two operations have a given. Is empty and is full. So by checking the two operations we are going to be conclude that. Then we can insert the data into the stack. That was a simple work of the stack. Thank you. So we know what is the linked list. Screen is visible. My screen is visible. So single linked list and double linked list and circular linked list. And so here, so simple only. I'm going to just briefing about the. So the single linked list we have. So here the linked list, the data is going to be one node concept. The node contains the two parts, one is a data part, another one is a link part. So here mainly the few parts, data part and view part. So operations what we can perform, we can insert. So insertion, again, we have different types of operations. Whether the data is going to be inserted at the beginning or end of the list, or a specific place also we can insert. So that's why it is a popular compared to the stack. In the stack, we can perform all the operations at one end only. So insertion or deletion may be. Then another one, we need to know about deletion. Generally, before that, we know about what is the deletion. Same deletion at the beginning, deletion at the end. So before knowing this deletion, we need to confirm about the traverse also. Why we need to traverse? So we don't know which data is going to be deleted. Which data is going to be deleted, we don't know. So such that, what data we need to confirm first. Then we need to find the data where it is available over the queue, over the tables. Then, so if one first time, for example, we need to know about the first value. So whether the value are going to be deleted, no. Then what we have to traverse to the next one. Next. So deletion, definitely we need to traverse to the different list, then only we can perform the deletion operation. So here also we have deletion at the beginning, deletion at the end of the list, and deletion after the specified mode or traversing and the section. So these are the operations we can perform. So what is the double link index? So here also we have a node, but node we have three parts of it. So one is a data node, another two parts are the previous link node and next link node. So we have so previous, that is a next pointer and a previous pointer. So we know what is a pointer, address of the variable. So there we have the reference of the next link node. So again, we have double link index, same operations, traverse and deletion also same. Then circular link list. So again, the last node, the last address is going to be again specified to the head. So that is a single circular link list. So the operations are circular link list, again, same operations. All the operations we can do here. Inserting at the end, inserting at the beginning, deletion at the beginning, deletion at the end, and the traversing section. So again, since we have a double link list, same operations. So we already saw these tags with last master. So this is the ordered list. So I told you what the definition we need to remember. So please forget about the link. So it is an order list with insertion and deletion performs at the one end, that is known as a graph. Stack is a recursive data structure having a pointer in the column. So what are the applications of stack? Recursion, expression evaluation, conversion, parsing. So parsing and browsers and editors, tree travels. So operations we can perform push and pop. So not only that, we have a peak operation also. So what is the peak operation? Peak will return always the top of the stack. What is the element in the stack? That is going to be there. So this is the one. So these are the things we need to remember. When it is empty, the top position is minus one. Only one element, that is zero. The stack is full, n minus 1, stack is overflow. So that is why again here bits. Again, in the same array, it is have the position, top position is 0 to the values is going to be stored. So the stack is full, the stack full size, the same is n minus 1. So for example, it is a stack size is 5, then the 0 to 4, the top is going to be filled. So that is so the array implementation or stack, adding an element into the stack push operation, adding an element into the top of the stack is referred as a push operation. So study we discuss separately also. So link to link implementation by using a stack. So same way how the stack. So once please be remember these combinations. In the first unit we already know about the data structure concept very well. In the previous years, second year we learned data structure. If you are very clear with that, here we need to know about the combinations. Link to list array implementation of stack. Array implementation of view for the stack implementation, that linked list implementation of stack. So here we are implementing the linked list of the stack means what? So the stack, the concept we should not link. But we have linking concept is there, but we should not take over the basic concept of stack, we should not use. So that's why you see that even the linked list is one after one we are going to be representing. When we are going to be mentioning the manner of the stack, see that it is going to be top level. So top, we are going to be mentioning a stack, this is the first value, this is the second value, third value. So the linking will be there to one value to another value. For example, the node, the first data is contained the known as the first node. So again, the first node in the linked list is going to be contained the two parts, one is the data part, another one is the link. The same. Again, we have a queue, front and back. So here also people. So queue can be defined as the order list, which is able to insert the elements. One end is called wrap, division performs. Another end is called. So applications of queue. So where we can use the queues. So again here, so how we are going to be implement the queue by using array? How we are going to be implement by using arrays? So here the queue, array representation of queue. So if the concept of array in the queue means definitely we need to give that index numbers. Through the index numbers, we need to mention this queue. So after deleting one element, so where we can delete, in the front we can delete, where we can insert it. So operations on linked queues, insertion operation. So here only we saw about this, and remember the concept of what is this, MLR. Why we are going with MLR? Why we are going with MLR? In order to implement, so if there is any data we are going to be insert, the data definitely contains two parts. While we are going to be implementing the linked list, definitely the data contains another part. So in order to mention or in order to implement the size, dynamically means runtime we are going to be taking. So arrays are compile time we can go into in linked list we can do dynamic. So the deletion is going to be performed. So for that only I gave an example for this with the A of the equal to this one and how we are going to do it and what is going to be for A of 10, what the value is going to be. Have you solved these exercises? Have you solved these exercises? Okay. So these are the simple examples of how we are going to be doing it. So once we have a declaration of array in compile time, so once we need to change anything, we need to go back with the program. Programmer data, then we need to change it. But we cannot. For example, why we are specifying that, sir, with the dynamic memory also, we want to increase the So how many values we are going to be enter? We are going to be asking here. So here, how many values we want to enter? And what is the difference between this and this? So I told you this is one is a compile time, then another one is a timing. So what is the difference? So in a programming, once the program is done in Java, we can create a jar. As you remember, I told you what is a jar. It is a simple executable file. Once the executable file is, we can run so many times. Okay. So this option will come. For example, how many times you are going to be run the program, that many times it is going to be. Can you see these programming lines in your jar file? No. Can you change the programming code by using a jar file? No. So that's why we can run. So when running, for example, how many values? 4 values. So when perform the operation, we can close it. So for example, we need to do the same program for 5 values. We can run again and 5 values. Once the MLL function is going to be run, so running the program itself, we can assign a memory for how many values we are going to be inside. For here, we need to know the programming code. Then we need to go to the programming lines. We can edit the memory. We can do it. So that is the difference between those. So in here we have some queue problem is there. So in order to overcome this queue, we have circular queues are there. So again, another important things are the sets. You know what is sets are there. The set is a fundamental concept of mathematics. Generally, we have parentheses, normal brackets is there. In brackets, we are going to represent the data. So Eclipse. First important distinction between the finite and infinite sets. So what type of sets are there means we have a finite set and infinite set. So a finite set represented by some kind of explicit enumeration data structure. You know what is enumeration? So assigning values to the variables. Variable names, assigning values to the variable names. Various elements, for example, we can call that as elements. We are assigning a values to the elements. So how we can mention sets? See that in the parentheses we are going to be write the values, for example, a equal to this. So here again we have an order list and an unordered list also there. So order means sorted. Sorted list and unordered list. That is, we can know is not a sorted list also. So sets may be set representation is a tree. How we are going to be represent by the tree also we can represent. So order list, unordered list, and the binary trees. How we are going to be represent. So we have a set of 5 values. How we are going to be represent. So for this, I already sent you one document. What is the main difference between general trees, binary search trees, and AVL trees, red block trees, place tree, tree, and B tree, and another one, B place tree also there. So what are the various types of trees also there? So here we have some new terminologies we have to know that. So by that we need to know what is the data, what is the node, where the data is available, how to find the data, how to arrange the data in the particular node, whether it is a left or right node. So how we can, so once we can fix the data into the nodes, whether we have a traverse of the data or we can arrange the data balancing tree, we have various concepts are available in this also. So in the service it is not mentioned, that's why I simply gave the overview of the trees. So what are the operations we can perform on sets? So what type of values? So that's when this is a very much useful while we are going to be creating clusters. See that element should not be repeated. Element should have a reason to be set. So this is very, very important. What is that? Element should be have a reason to be in the set. So have you remember the concept of cluster? What is a cluster? So how we can group a nodes into a cluster? I told you something similarity is there to group the data. That groups are known as a cluster. That groups are known as a cluster. Okay. How we are going to be the examples for you. That is how we are going to be good for the E server. So here we have see that A, B, C, D, E. A is a vendor, A is B's friend, and B is his friend. So I can do these three because A is a friend of B, then B is a friend of C. So we have something relationship between these three. That's why I am going to group this connect each other. Then D is a list friend. So that is how we can move another thing. Another set. So that is. Then what are the operations of the set? So the set contribution. So union and you can find. So union means we can combine the two sets. Find means we can find a particular value. Find whether the two elements A and B are connected or not. So that means the particular two elements are in the same list or different list. The same list means that is connected. We can find. So that is a set of operations. These are some examples also. We have 10 elements are there. So how we are going to be compared with how we can insert, how we can group it. So union 2,1. We can combine with the 2,1. I think this is a very simple concept. We are clear with the last time itself, I think so. So how we are going to be doing the union operations. We will see the generics in the next class. Maybe this is a timeout. If you have any doubts, you can post it. If you ask me, I will explain 1 minute because the next class will be.